Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I hope everyone's doing well. I am Chad from CD Shaving. Tonight we are doing another soap review, but not just any soap review. We are revisiting local Gent shaving company, Lime Street Shaving Soap. 5 days ago, I did a review on this soap. I did not rate it very well, and for a number of reasons. The scent I didn't like, mostly the lather. And I got a comment on it, and I was given some pointers on this particular soap. Apparently, this soap requires special attention in some areas. So we're going to revisit this soap and pay special attention to those areas to try to give it another shot, see if we can't make it work for us. One of the things I was told was not enough surface area. So we're going to crack this baby open in the Tupperware dish that it is in right now. I mashed it down even further. Before, it was just the single puck that was in there. It was about an inch and a half, I believe, maybe 2 inches wide. Mashed it down to cover the entire bottom of the container. I was told that this particular soap requires more surface area to provide a better loading. So, looking at this here, I don't know if you can see that. We're probably looking at roughly 2.5 inches, all right, for surface area. Here's another soap, Crema di Barba, Bergamotto Neroli. And this one has, about 2.5 there. And let's go with Barrister and Man, that one. Has 3 on the dot, so it's got just under 1/2 inch of surface area to load with, and I have no problem loading with this, and I've not had any problem loading with the soaps that come in these containers here from this company and other companies like it. So I'm going to go ahead and give it a shot, and I've increased the surface area to load it here. Also been told that these soaps a little dry; they like to be really, really hydrated. I have a lot of different soaps I've gone through. I'm pretty experienced at lathering, especially with bowl lathering and fin face lathering I'm getting into now too. So haven't really had too much of an issue. This one's proven a little bit of a challenge to me. But we're gonna go with these suggestions. We're gonna hydrate the heck out of it. We increase the surface tension on it. I'm also gonna take it another step further and go with a different brush. Last time I used my Omega synthetic, which has not a whole lot of backbone to it, which I generally like. However, we're going to go with my Omega boar hair. Yeah, boar hair. This one has a lot more backbone to it, a little bit stiffer brush. So we're going to go with this. We're going to load the crap out of it in here. And after we're done loading it, as much as we can get it loaded, and we'll make sure it's really hydrated this time, we're going to bowl lather. Okay, we're going to bowl lather. We're going to add even more water to it. I know I don't want to overhydrate it. I get that, and I'm not looking to do that. But I do want to give this soap as fair of a shot as possible. These are the pointers that I was given from the staff over at Local Gent Shaving Company. Their soap, their rules. I want to see if I can make this work. So here we're going to go, folks. We're going to get this soap bloomed, get it ready to go. Tonight for the shave, I'm going to be using my Razor Rock German 37 on its... Third use feather blade. I keep track of that on a little grease board, all the different razors and blades that I use. Because I shave both my head and my face, it's hard to keep track. So anyway, went with the feather blade third use on my Razor Rock 37. You can see there, blade is pretty well even all around, nice and aligned, ready to go, rock and roll. We're going to do some water, get the sink filled up with water. Don't need that. And we're going to go ahead and get the soap bloomed. And we're going to do a head shave tonight. All right, we'll do a head shave. Get this thing all nice and slick, hopefully. Go from there. So we're going to be right back. Thanks for joining us at CD Shaving. Glad to have you here. Watch another video. So we're going to get this thing going on here. We'll be right back. Okay, welcome back. It is Chad from CD Shaving. We are doing our second review of the Local Gent Shaving Company. Lime Street. Second attempt at a review here. First review was done 5 days ago. Was not overly favorable by me. And apparently missed a couple of steps in using their soaps. Require a little bit more water, a little bit of time and attention when it comes to surface area for lab for loading. And I decided to go with a different brush. So I had my brush soaking here. My Omega Pure Boar Hair. We're going to be going with that. My puck is blooming. Blade is hot. I'm going to fill up the rest of the sink here with the water. I got the bowl warming up here. We're going to go ahead and take this bloom water. Throw it on my head. We're doing a head shave, by the way. As I said before, the scent is not overly powerful for me. I'm a really heavy scent guy, like a heavy scent. And this is, you can smell it. It does smell like a fresh cut lime, which is what they go for in their description. However, it is not, it's not overly powerful. So, anyway, so that's my take on that. So we get this going on. We're only going to knock. All right, so the thing's still pretty saturated. Ready to go. Let's rock and roll here. Let's rock and roll here. I'm going to mash the shit out of this. And if we have to, we'll add more water. So I'm just going ahead in here. I'm going to load this. I usually load soaps about 30 seconds, sometimes 40. You know, it really kind of depends on the soap. This particular soap, I think I'm going to just keep loading, you know. I'm even going to get some of the frothy crap out of there that people don't always like. I'm going to try to load as much of this soap, the actual soap itself. I mean, I usually hang on to this stuff. I don't know. It just seems to... I usually leave it in the container, actually. Some people, they load it upside down like this to get rid of it. And, which I get, I do. But, I mean, I found that it just hardens back up into the soap when you're done. So what's the big deal if it stays in the container? At least that's been my experience anyway. Anyway, so... But... You know, I want to give this thing a fair shot here. All right, we're loading. This is damn near a minute here. And we're starting to actually turn that into a lather. That's pretty well loaded. I mean, that... Yeah, I mean, look at that. It's starting to lather anyway. So we're going to take this stuff out of here. All the cream that kind of came. So that's what we're left with. But, you know, we want to try to lather this itself or turn it into a lather. So we need the bowl here. I'm even going to just put a trace of water in there. And here we go. Here we go. I mean, it starts off by, you know, doing, I'll add some more water to it though. Fingers are a little wet with the water. All right, so I've got this so far. And I'm going to add some more water here. Actually, you know what? I'm going to do it this way. There. That was probably a little bit more water than I normally would put in any soap. But you guys said it's a thirsty soap. Let's see. All right. I just put all that water into it, and that's what I got out of it. All right. So, okay, I'll give you that. I added more water to it, and I wonder if that doesn't do much for the scent, but that's fine. All right, I will admit the lather definitely exploded more on the second time I'm doing this by adding more. I added way more water than I do to any soap, and it seems to fare well with it. So I'm gonna really kind of spend a little extra time here on this to see what I can get it to do. Well, I mean, that's pretty covered. So, I don't know if you can really see the consistency there. I mean, it's pretty solid. I'm not solid. I mean, that's what it should be at. It's not dripping off. There's a couple of water air bubbles in there I'd like to work out, but so you can see, that's what I ended up with, which is, I don't know if you can quite tell. There you go. You can get the light in there. That's a fair amount of lather in there. So, all right. The ladies and gentlemen over at Local Gent. Okay, add more water. So this soap can lather or can bowl lather pretty well. I mean, that's a lot. I mean, if you can see how full that is. I'd say that this bowl is about halfway full. It just requires a lot of water. Okay, so now let's talk about performance here. All right, let's get a little bit on the brush handle. I'm just going to wipe some of that off. Just because I don't want to drop the brush. I don't know how slick this is. I got my Allen block here. I always shave with the Allen block right nearby. Holds a good grip on this. Throw some water on my head because my head started to dry a little bit. Scoop up some of this. All right, let's go into a head lather here. Incidentally, hope everyone's doing well. I don't know if you guys have plans next weekend. Easter weekend's coming up. Da Bunny will be here. So whatever you guys have for plans. Losing a couple of hairs here. Anyway, whatever you guys have for plans, I hope they turn out well. I hope you guys you're having plenty of people over if you're having a gathering. Okay. Now you can see that. That's not a bad lather at all. I'm going to give you that. It feels all right. You know, it obviously the proof is in the pudding. It'll see how it shaves. I had actually gotten away from my boar hair brush because it tends to eat a lot of my soaps unnecessarily. I was realized that by a friend of mine one day when he told me how much soap I was using. And I said, wasn't that normal? And he says, well, no, I mean, look at how much, you know, that should last you the X, Y, and Z. And I, you know, through talking to him, we discovered that it was actually the boar hair brush. The synthetic and the badger use a lot less hair. I mean, a lot less soap. So anyway, but that's fine. If this particular soap requires a brush with some more backbone, so be it. I got one of those, and I can always suggest that to people that want to try this soap. So, all right, let's give this bad boy a first round here. Got a razor, find that angle, and let's go for that first shave. Here we go. Haven't had a head shave in a couple of days, so I'm kind of looking forward to this. I don't like the scratchy feeling. Like, I can deal with it on my face for for a day or two. But when it comes to my head, it drives me nuts. Drives me batty. All right, right off, I can tell you, it still feels a little dry to me. The lather does. Maybe my head needed some more water on it, but we'll see how I'll change that out. I'll put more water on my head during the second pass. But we're just going with the grain here. Now, it's interesting because a lot of people, not a lot of people, I think some people don't take that first pass quite as seriously as they should. They say, well, this is only the first pass. You're only going with the grain. You don't have to be as careful or whatnot. You most certainly do. I mean, you got to be real careful when shaving anyway, and with any kind of razor, but especially these things. And that first pass is important. I mean, it sets up the whole rest of the shave. If you have a shitty first pass, your subsequent passes aren't going to be any good. So you want to really kind of concentrate on what you're doing, you know, and mind your trouble areas. If you've got a mole or a certain spot on your head or your face, rather, that doesn't usually fare well to carelessness, just because it's your first pass and you've got a boatload of lather on there and you're going, this is just getting it started. Don't take it for granted. Don't do that, because you're gonna end up in Cuttsville. Yeah. And Cuttsville sucks. I've been to Cuttsville many times. And Cuttsville place is kind of bland because they only like one color, red. Now, I am not kind of at a disadvantage because of where the camera is, because I can't open the mirrors to see my entire head. So I'm going off of feel, and I've been doing this a long time where I can pretty much do this without looking, my head anyway. And I can hear it. It's got that little spot right up there. All right. Okay, first pass, just about there. First pass, just about done. We're going to go ahead and rinse off and see how we did here. All right, not bad. Some residual slickness is left. We're going to go ahead and put the brush back on and get ready for our second pass here. So I'm going to lather up, we'll do our second pass, and I'll get right back with our comments on that, see how we did. Be right back. Just wanted to take a minute. I just lathered up for the second pass, and I just wanted to take a minute and show you the brush. There's still plenty of lather in there, and I still got a ton left in the bowl. So definitely adding all that water to it definitely helped, and taking extra time to load it definitely helped, make it really explode and make it a little bit more functional. So we're going to go ahead and see how this does with that second pass. Like I said, we'll be right back. All right, we're back after that second pass. I love that razor. It shaves so well on my head. Still get some slickness, a little bit more than what I had before on that first one when I did the first review, when I did it on my face. But yeah, I think the shave is going okay so far. The scent is still gone. I mean, the scent is, I don't have no scent on this at all as of right now. Plenty of lather. It definitely exploded. The cushion is there. Slickness is okay. It is not the slickest soap I have, but it is slicker than it was. So I'm going to give this another shot. We're going to go with our third pass cross grain. I went this way just now. Now I'm going to go back this way and get some more of that hair off. And we're then we'll be going into a final pass and a cleanup. So we'll be right back. All right. So third pass is done. Cross grain other direction. Not bad. I mean, I got to be honest with you. It's not bad. I don't. The scent, like I said, is still not there, but that's fine. The performance, slickness, you know, my razor definitely is gliding a lot more than it was on the first review. So I definitely think adding water to that was the key, like they said. So, but we're going to go ahead and do this. We're going to go against the grain because that's a real test for me. We're going to do against the grain, clean up pass. We'll wipe some of this wipe down some of the sink. We'll come back with you with our final thoughts on the soap. Go from there. We'll wrap this up. Thanks for watching so far. We'll be right back. All right, we are back. I did against the grain, and I did a cleanup pass. All right, so everything is taken care of here. I just did a little bit of treatment with some witch hazel, T.N. Dickinson's witch hazel. It's unscented. I went with there. Tonight, again, we went with the Omega boar hair, pure boar hair brush. And just to recap, we reviewed for the second time, local Gent Lime Street soap. We're going to be going with Sandpiper Sterling Aftershave Balm, and we're going to pair that with the Sandpiper Aftershave. Now, we also used the Razor Rock German 37 slant bar with a feather blade on its third use. Again, so tonight's review, second time for the soap. It did a lot better than the first. I will admit it. The cushion was there. The lather was there. Ease of loading was not. It loaded, but it took a little while. Is this a soap that I would reach for? No, but there's a caveat to that. One, I'm a huge scent guy. I like scents. It's a nice scent. It's just not big enough for me. It's not a soap that I wouldn't use. It's just not one I would look at and go, I want that one. Based on the scent and also based on the amount of work it took to load and create the lather. I mean, it requires a stiff backbone brush, in my opinion, and it requires a lot of water. So, yeah, I could probably get the water ratio down a little bit, you know, after using it a couple of times, but to me, it's still a little bit finicky. And if I'm in a hurry, the last thing I want to do is grab for a finicky soap. I might use it on a day when I'm not in a rush and I'm just kind of a weekend day where I've got nothing going on and I just want to get a nice shave in. Yeah, okay, I'd go and grab it. But again, there's the scent to me. It's just not really there. But if you're a type of person who likes a light scented soap, yeah, I would recommend this. Just not something to use if you're in a hurry. But if you're not in a hurry, you shouldn't really be rushing when you're going to do a shave like this anyway. So if you got a day when you get some time and you like a light scented soap, yeah, I'd go with this. I would. It'll do you right. So just make sure you use a stiff backbone brush and you should be good. So anyway, so thanks very much for watching. Don't forget to like the video if you liked it and don't forget to subscribe and hit the unlike button if you didn't like it. Either way, I'd like feedback, good or bad. It doesn't matter to me, or indifferent. That's fine too. So those of you who are going to shave tonight, I hope you have a good shave. Thank you very much for watching, and we'll see you next time.